My name is April Heron, and I serve as a special education supervisor for Blount County Schools. I welcome each one of you to the 6th annual Project Search celebration. I am proud to see the vision for Project Search in Blount County has been successful for 6 years. Each year is special as we continue our mission of 100% employment. It takes many parts to accomplish this great work, and I want to show appreciation to these parts at this time. Parents, thank you for the love and support that you show to your sons and daughters as they pursue such great goals. Teachers and school staff, thank you for the long hours educating on core subjects and life skills. Maryville College, the Project Search host business, thank you for the privilege of being part of the Scotts family. Vocational Rehabilitation, thank you for the years spent with each student and family in ongoing conversations and planning towards transition. The Access Program, thank you for your faithful service in coaching interns for workplace readiness. Business Advisory Council, thank you for networking with community resources to support employment for individuals with disabilities. Steering Committee, thank you for seeing the vision of Project Search in Blount County 6 years ago and for continuing that vision of excellence as we move forward. Project Search Instructor Tammy Heron and Employment Specialist Sandy Osborne and Sharon Bolden, thank you for the intense focus that on preparing our interns for success in life with a job. Interns, thank you for staying the course with courage and drive to get that job that you are so ready to do. We reserve this time to celebrate you. As we continue our celebration, Mr. Mike Brewer will share an introduction of our interns.
Hello, my name is Mike Brewer. I serve as the Special Education Coordinator for Blount County Schools. It is my pleasure to introduce to you the 2020-2021 Project Search interns. From Heritage High School, Aaron McAndrew. Daughter of Robert and Sharon McAndrew, Aaron is completing her intern rotations at the Metz Cafe, in the bakery, and in the dish room. Emily Wynn, daughter of Heather Watson and John Wynn. Emily enjoyed the intern rotation at the Metz Cafe, in the dish room, and in the dining hall. Jacob Wynn, son of Heather Watson and John Wynn, Jacob completed his intern rotation at William Blount in the maintenance department. Now from William Blount High School, Dylan Pizzatello.
Correct.
Son of Shayna Burns. Dylan's last rotation in his intern experience was in the William Blount cafeteria. David Vaughn, son of Barry and Georgia Vaughn. David's intern experiences included the cafeteria and maintenance department at William Blount High School. Congratulations on completing your Project Search internship experience. I'm very proud of your commitment in completing this program and preparing for employment. It's been a joy to get to know you and to see your growth throughout the year. Interns, I wish you much success in the future. As we continue our celebration, Project Search instructor Ms. Tammy Herron will share program highlights of this year. Congratulations, interns.
Good morning, and I'm happy to be here this morning. This is our sixth year for Project Search. We've had a very successful year. I'm very proud of our interns. They have been a wonderful group, especially during this COVID year when things have been difficult for us and different, quite a different picture this year for us. So, but I had a great group this year, and I'm very thankful for my team, and I'm thankful for the parents and for the interns who have been supported this year. Before I move on, there are two special ladies that I want to introduce to you today. They are the backbone and core of Project Search. They are my job coaches. And I'm gonna let them come up and introduce themselves and say just a few words about this year at Project Search and maybe how different it's been, how fabulous it's been. We'll see what they have to say. We're going to start with Sharon Bolden from the Access Program.
Hello, my name is Sharon Bolden, and I work for the Access Program as a workplace readiness specialist or job coach, and I've enjoyed it a lot. I love working with these kids. I've enjoyed watching them grow into their adulthood, independent, getting ready to go out to work. We've had a wonderful year. Thank you, interns, for such a wonderful year.
And next we have Sandy Osborne. She's from William Blount High School, and she is a job coach for us. So here she comes. Hope your applause.
Hello, like she said, I'm Sandy Osborne, and I've had the pleasure of working with these interns and coaching alongside them. This past year, I've watched them build upon their work skills and gain new skills, and they have learned how to be successful employees. They've taken on more responsibilities at home. Parents might be quite surprised. They might be doing some things. They may be packing a lunch at night before. They may be setting their own alarm clocks, making sure their clothes are washed and ready for the next day. I am extremely proud of them. Also, they're learning how to use public transportation. And as they work in the rotations, I've noticed that some of them, they changed their vision about the type of job that they wanted. So Project Search was really good for them in that they were able to broaden their horizons and think of other things, and think outside the box and find other things that they were interested in doing. And I'm proud of each and everyone that did assignments at home, in the classroom, and virtually. And some days we weren't really sure, but you know, we had snow days, and some days we worked virtually, and some days we did not. And so we were really thankful when we had a true snow day, where we got to stay at home and not crack a Chromebook, right? They carried their Chromebooks and notebooks filled with worksheets everywhere they went. They told them Maryville College and back and forth to school. It was definitely a different kind of year. They wore face masks and face shields without any complaints. And they wore aprons and gloves and hairnets too. Could almost be like a little song, couldn't it? Mm-hmm. And everyone was flexible and they adapted well to the changes that were made along the way. Just amazing, just simply amazing. And they used hand sanitizer every time they came into the classroom. And they really took care of each other and they wore their masks. just simply amazing, with little complaint. And I know how hot and very tiring it is wearing a mask day in and day out. So thank you, interns, for a wonderful year. I'm proud of each and every one of you. I really am. Now go and do great things.
Okay, before we start, we're going to talk a little bit about some of the things we learned this year. But before I do that, I want to take a moment and let the interns introduce themselves and tell you a little bit about themselves. And we're going to start with David Vaughn.
I'm David Vaughn, and I'm 20 years old. I work at Union Grove. And I have three dogs, and I enjoy skateboarding. And Project Search means a lot because it's helped me find a job.
Dylan.
Hello, I'm Dylan Picciutello. I'm from William Blount, and I work for William Blount now. What Project Search means to me is getting to the end goal of school and starting life. Some of the things that I like to do is help raise animals and also fix computers and other electronics.
Good, Dylan. Okay, we're to Emily Rebecca Wynn.
Hi, my name is Rebecca Wynn, and I'm from Heritage High School, and 20 years old. And one thing I like about Project Search is it helped me find a job at William Blount High School. Can I tell you?
Okay, and next we have Aaron McAndrew.
Hi, I'm Aaron McAndrew. I'm 10 years old. And I work at Mary College. And then I followed the directions. And there was this system and had area. It was the set of rules. I could never put out of my therapy permission.
Okay, so thank you, Aaron. And they have all mentioned, many of them are already employed, and we're going to talk about that in just a minute, but we're going to talk about some of the things we learned in Project Search this year. So every morning, we talked about some skills that we needed to have. What was one of the things Ms. Heron said every morning? Why do people lose their jobs? David?
Because they don't know how to behave.
Because they don't know how to behave. That's right. And I always said stop and
think.
Stop and think when you're making a decision. So we talked about universal job skills a lot this year, skills that you need no matter what job you go to. So I'm going to ask my interns to tell me some universal job skills.
Honesty.
Being honest. David, can you tell me a couple? Having a good attitude. Can you boys think of another one?
Calling in / being on time.
Calling in, being on time. What about Emily? What about staying in your
area?
Staying in your area. Aaron, using good what? Industrial?
The hand hygiene.
Hand washing, very good. Staying on?
Task.
Task. If you don't understand, what are you supposed to do?
Stop and think.
Ask someone, aren't you?
Yes.
Another thing, the unit we talked about was being prepared for work. So what are some of the things you can do to be prepared for work?
Laying out your clothes the night before.
Lay your clothes out the night before. David? Pack your lunch. Set your what? Alarm?
Alarm clock.
Yeah, make sure you've got a what?
Good attitude.
A good attitude. Make sure you've called Ethra. You set up your transportation. Then we talked, spent an enormous amount of time speaking about safety because that's so important as they leave us. So I'm going to ask you guys just to shout out some safety rules.
Oh, I know one. One that we had back in MITS was stay away from hot areas.
Stay out of the hot areas.
Never mix chemicals.
Don't throw walnuts.
Don't throw walnuts. And if you've ever been to Maryville College, you will know why you don't throw walnuts. They're like this big, and if you hit somebody with one, it's going to be very painful. Aaron, what's a safety rule?
Nobody.
Never leave campus? Without Ms. Heron's permission, that's right. We talked a lot about don't ride with who?
I don't ride with anybody you don't know.
Nobody you don't know. And what also do you need to be able to do? Speak up for your
rights.
Your own rights. That's right. We talked a lot about that, speaking up for your rights. We also talked about budgeting, and I'm going to throw this to Emily. Emily, what are the three main things that we talked about when we spoke about budgeting?
Income, wants, and needs.
Income, wants, and needs. We also talked about debit and credit cards. And what's your PIN number?
I'm not telling you.
See, that's a good answer. He's not telling us. It's your personal identification number. So do we give that out?
No.
Here's one. Why do we not write checks in pencil?
You could erase it and forge.
It could be erased. We talked about counting money and budgeting money. When we count money, we counted by what? Touch points?
Fives.
Fives. And what do we count last?
Ones.
We count our ones last, and they are in the shape of a what? Penny.
Penny.
We count our pennies last. And then we also talked about functional reading. And we talked about dividing words into syllables. So tell me the three main syllable rules. If you have this big word and you don't know what it is, what are you going to do?
Divide it.
It has to have a... What does it have to have?
A vowel.
A vowel. It has to have a vowel. And then you try to divide between the what? Double what?
Consonants.
Consonants, and you never, ever...
Separate a digraph?
Break a digraph. Isn't that right, Aaron?
Yes.
Then you can type that word right out. So you can see we have had a wonderful year this year. The interns have been absolutely fabulous. Lastly, I want to introduce somebody who was a game changer for us this year. It's an honor and a privilege to work for him. It's Mr. Rob Clark. When I came down and was a little taken back by the changes that were going to be at Maryville College this year, they went out for Thanksgiving and didn't come back. Mr. Clark was like, "It's okay, Tammy. Let's just work out a plan where they can come here and work." And it opened some very important doors for us because he welcomed us to William Blount, and they were allowed to work in the maintenance and the cafeteria. And that resulted in four interns getting a job because of the way that he thought about placing the interns. So we ended up with David at Union Grove Middle School because he was recommended by Miss Fawn at William Blount. We have Dylan, who's at William Blount High School. We have Emily, who's at William Blount High School. And we have another intern, Jacob, who will be in the maintenance department at William Blount. So we have a special award for Mr. Clark. And it says, "The Blount County Project Search family wishes to extend our most sincere appreciation to Rob Clark for being dedicated to the success of the Project Search interns and the advancement of their employment goals. Your contribution positively impacts the Blount County community." Thank you, Mr. Clark. It's a joy to work with you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
So as Ms. Heron said, I'm Rob Clark, the principal at William Blount High School. And I'd like to take this opportunity to thank the entire Project Search team, from Ms. Harris to April Heron, our folks at Maryville College. It takes a team to make this program so successful. Most importantly, I want to take the time to congratulate our student interns. And when we as teachers and principals, when we come to work every day, it's our privilege to see you guys grow into the young people that you are. Your responsibility, the work skills that you've learned, we're awfully proud of you. I've got the privilege to introduce the William Blount interns, and to talk about their employment opportunities with us. David Vaughn here is employed by Union Grove Middle School in the cafeteria. And David, your ability to be honest and courteous will be great attributes for you at Union Grove. And then Dylan Pizzatello is employed with us as well through ESS. He works in our cafeteria, and he mentioned earlier that it's important to be on time. I see him and Emily every day clocking in at 7:30 every morning. They're always on time, and they're always eager to work. I'm awfully proud of you all. At this time, I'd like to turn the program over to Jed West from Heritage High School.
Thank you, Mr. Clark. I'd like to echo your sentiments. It's an awfully proud moment anytime we have our students move on and be successful, but it's especially proud for this group of students that have worked so hard and put in tremendous effort this year in learning and gaining tremendous skills. We are excited to recognize our Heritage High School Project Search interns. First, let me start with Aaron McAndrew. Aaron is currently seeking employment and is interested in retail. It's no surprise, Princess. Aaron, your ability to get along well with others and your sweet personality will serve a new employer very well. We are very proud of you, Aaron. We'd also like to recognize Emily Rebecca Wynn. Emily has recently been hired by ESS to work in the cafeteria at William Blount High School to help serve food and assist with the food preparation. Rebecca, your ability to stay focused on your tasks and excellence and attention to detail will serve the William Blount Cafeteria very well. We're very proud of you. And unfortunately, Jacob could not be with us, but we also wanted to recognize Jacob Wynn. Jacob is in the process of being hired and is currently working through a temporary probationary status with William Blount High School to work in the maintenance department. Jacob's ability to follow instructions and be attentive to tasks will serve William Blount High School very well. We are so proud of Jacob. As we continue our celebration, I'm going to turn it over to Dr. Coker with the president of Maryville College, and he will share some closing comments.
All right, hello everyone. Once again, I'm Brian Coker, and I have the real privilege of serving as the 12th president of Maryville College. I'm so pleased to be part of this sixth annual Project Search celebration, and I bring greetings to you on behalf of the faculty, staff, and students of Maryville College. Congratulations to all of the interns today, and also to the parents, teachers, staff, and families who make all of this possible. We know that these accomplishments do not happen alone. It truly does take a village, as they say. Maryville College is honored and proud to be a partner in Project Search, and we are grateful for the interns' roles in helping the college fulfill our educational mission. As the college's president, I just give lots of speeches and send a lot of email. But it's in our dining hall and in our campus facilities functions where the real work of keeping the college going truly takes place. Having assumed the Maryville presidency at the height of the pandemic, as I was telling the interns earlier, not something I necessarily recommend, but again, having assumed it then, my opportunities to see Project Search in action have unfortunately been limited this year. However, I have heard a great deal about the program, and I am deeply impressed with the passion for and dedication to Project Search and the notable mission of 100% employment. Again, congratulations to the honorees, and thank you for your important role in fulfilling the educational mission of Maryville College. And now, as we continue the closure of the celebration, I'm pleased to turn things over to Mr. Brett. Dr. Brett, thank you again.
As with every year, it is always a distinct privilege and honor to address the young folks here and to praise the Project Search team. It certainly has been a very trying and most challenging year. Young people, for you, but also your teachers and those folks that are helping you along your path and journey. So I want to take this opportunity on behalf of the Blount County school community to thank your principals, to thank our special ed supervisor, April and Mike back there, as well as your teachers and your coordinators and folks that are helping you. And I want to also thank our team back here that are behind the scenes, but nevertheless doing a lot of the legwork on your behalf as well. Interns, congratulations on your graduation from Project Search. What a great program this is. I can remember distinctly some nearly 7 years ago when the special ed director, Amanda Vance, at that time, came into my office and says, Mr. Britt, would you entertain an idea? It's a little bit out there on the innovative end and of things. And so I sat intensely and listened to her pitch at that time, and I said, absolutely, this is something we have to do. And Amanda took that, and her and the team here, and now April, Mike, all the folks have just rallied around and built this thing better and better and better each and every year. So I'm very, very grateful on the Blount County Schools. Very, very grateful for the community and the great expertise that they have lended to this program and the continuation of this program. Interns, this program would not be possible without your hard work, your attention to detail, and all of the great things that you provide our employers. I want to thank Dr. Coker and everyone at Maryville College and their participation, certainly William Blount High School this year for lending and opening your doors to the workforce of these young folks. That's quite a tribute. You know, when things get crazy in a pandemic, and you know, you have to adapt, you have to be resilient, you have to do those things, and you all have demonstrated all of those traits that will make you successful in life. Even through a pandemic, you found a way to continue to use your skills and to contribute significantly to our community. So I want to take this opportunity on behalf of the entire Blount County school community to thank you and say congratulations. Thank you.